everybody feel all right? Thank you so much for coming out here. I'm very, very happy that we have the room filled, and most of all that it's friends and family. So we're playing before a friendly crowd, because this is a premiere in many ways. It's a dream come true, actually, for me, because there's a little story behind this. And it started with our friend Phil McMillian.
He's here.
Somewhere.
Hurry, Phil.
Woo! Now, there he is. And it started with a Sunday jam session that we go to, all of us, Phil and these people here. And they used to meet in this very room. And Rob is one of them. And so that created some sort of a family. And at one point, Phil asked me if I wanted to join him on the cajon for a concert that he was about to give with his own originals. And I said, okay. And then we did a concert together. I mean, it's Phil's concert, and I was doing the cajon. And it was a nice crowd. And I thought, I want to do that too, because I write songs too. And I want to have an evening with songs that I write and people listening to my material. And so I asked people in the jam session, would you be interested in doing my songs and making my dream come true to have my songs presented to an audience live, which hadn't happened before? And they said, one by one, I think I asked Josh first, and then Bruce, and eventually we had band. And then we started practicing, and we practiced for a year. And it's another premiere for me too, because I've never played the drums in a band before. I did play with Phil and the Parsnips, but that was mainly cajon, and now here's a whole drum set. And now, first time I play a drum set, it's covered with towel.
It's too loud.
That's what Ringo did.
Ringo played the towel.
Everybody said Ringo did that, and it sounds like Ringo, only it isn't Ringo. So it's my first time on the drums, and half of this band has never played in a band live before, so this is really a new situation, and I think these guys are incredible talents, and they should have been in bands, all of them, long before. And the whole Sunday jam session is full of talents. One guy is sitting here, and you know, it's a family. And so let me see. Yeah, since we are not professionals, you will notice that these guys love looking at their texts better than looking at you. So don't take it personally. It's still a matter of concentration.
It's fascinating.
I keep telling them, look up. You know, we've been trying to memorize our songs, but he's the youngest.
We priced all the tickets accordingly. So,
we have 16 songs for you. We won't have a break. So feel free to get up and go to the bathroom. Feel free to dance if you like.
Dance in the bathroom, if you like.
It is 10 songs that I wrote, so if you don't know the song, it's probably mine. And we have 6 cover songs to not bore you. So if you recognize the song, then it's probably somebody else's original. Okay, so let me thank very much the people that made it possible for us to be here. First of all, Pam Simmons, who just disappeared, and her colleague, Scott Davis. Thank you, Pam. He did an incredible job of providing this room, and they put up the tables, and we organized this, and it was a marvelous job. It was tremendous, the best job in the world, believe me. I'd like to thank Mark, I have to look your last name, Mark Levy here, who's volunteered to do the mixing. And of course, I need to thank Bill Connors, who's not here yet, but he's coming, who has organized the meetup, the Sunday meetup. He's been organized that. Without that Sunday meetup, this thing wouldn't have happened either. And I'm very proud of this. And I think this is all I have here on my list. So the rest of the talking will be done by the band. I will withdraw through my towels. Forgive us for making mistakes. We're nervous, you know, but since you don't know the songs, you won't notice. Hopefully. Thank you. Have a great time. And enjoy yourself.
So you're
and, and thank you, Susan. Her husband, Steve, has baked those wonderful pretzels. Unfortunately, we can't provide one for everyone. Thank you. So now you do the talk. This is Laura's signature song. It's called Roundabout. Then we we thought, okay, let's keep the song, but do it with the sex. And so that's a different appeal. Going out the country.
Dave, fall back comfortably.
Camp Dave.
Thank you. time for your 12 string joke.
So the next one's a fella.
It's actually a harp joke.
That was a harp joke?
Yeah, a harpist is a person who spends half of their time tuning and the other half playing out of tune.
Go for the 12 string joke.
All I have to do is press harder, I think.
We've already got your money, you're not getting back.
Oh, when I went out the door today, I saw a dead swallow in front of our house. And that little swallow had fallen out of the nest. We have a nest on top of the door, and you can tell because the floor is full of shit. That one fell out, and we looked up and saw those three fat little swallows grating at us. And so I looked at that little dead bird, and I thought of this song, and it's called Learning to Fly.
And on that cheery note.
On that cheery note, yeah.
Whoa!
All right. Yeah, feel free
to
dance.
Patty!
Yeah.
Thank you. Mike Anderson's going to lead us off on this.
It's a little country stylish. It's called Another Lonely Fool.
And I blush because Millen's here and he sings it so well.
There's our friend Millen, and we used to do that together with Mike, and then Millen sang it, and he killed it, and now Mike is going to kill it again.
Mike is going to murder it.
Okay, here we go.
We start that part. Yep. Our song later.
One. Thank you.
next one's about problems at the airport.
Part of our mass transportation setup.
Yeah. No travel ban yet.
Ooh, if really? Only we had a song about trains.
It's a song I used to do with parsnips.
All right.
It's called Flying Tonight.
Three, four.
next song goes back to the 80s, and it's funny because I wrote this about the Russian president Gorbachev, and the original title was Leader, and it was very emotional to me. It was the time of the reunification and the falling of the wall, and the Scorpions. I don't know if you know the Scorpions. Had a huge hit with Winds of Change at that time, and it inspired me, so I wrote this kind of mushy song as a love confession to Gorbachev, because there was so much hope in it at the time of Perestroika and Glasnost, and that's all gone now. And then times changed, and I realized, well, I can't sing that song anymore. Not for Gorbachev, not as leader, and so I wrote a love song. Oh, I changed the tune to love lyrics, not tune, the lyrics. And it's called Lover now. And we are fortunate to have Josh sing it better than I can, and I'm very happy. This is
my favorite of Wolf's many songs. And, no pressure.
Thanks.
God, I was going to say that.
Yeah, I'm coming off like a whole month's worth of colds, so.
Thank you.
this schedule. And it's funny because one of the oldest Beatles songs is My Baby Got to Travel on One After 909. That's about railways and a station. And this is one of my oldest songs, and it's about railways and a station. And it's actually a true story. And I wanted to go to a party with my guys, and my mother said, I just have my driver's license. And she said, you got to take me to the station. I said, what? You know, she said, train's waiting, you got to drive me, you got a license now. I said, yeah, but I'm having the guys waiting for a party. She said, no way, I paid for your license. So this song is called I Have to Take My Mother to the Train Station. And Thomas is going to sing it for us. So, actually, it was written when I was young, so... For adult people, I don't know if we have to drive our mothers to train stations anymore. But that doesn't matter. You call me last night, asked if I wanted to come.
Thank you. He and I were practicing it one day, and I told him that this one always, this one makes me think of my brother. So, Crosby, Stills, and Nash did this one, and Graham Nash wrote it. He said, and this is about, you know, brothers that never got along, and they wasted a whole lot of time, you know, not talking to each other. And, you know, as time goes on, it's like my brother and I, we've, you know, kind of come to the center, or I don't see him as much as I'd like to, but this one's for him.
I am older now, I have more than what I
The Beatles covered this one, I believe.
The Beatles covered it, yeah.
I think I shrank like four inches.
The song, Rhythm and Blues R&B song. Beatles covered it.
The Beatles covered it back, and they started playing it back in the day when they were in Hamburg, right?
In a small club.
They were in small clubs. They were with really rough, dangerous crowds of sailors and prostitutes, kind of like you guys.
Because we're in a small club.
Without the sound of Beatles prostitutes.
Yeah, and that's on the first
but
album
we don't judge.
They were put out.
We don't judge.
Please, please me. Especially on a day like this. So, enjoy. Trying to imitate an English accent. Did you know this?
In America, it's America or foreign.
I can talk my German accent. That's
a foreign accent.
As soon as we start the band, we start talking with the British accent.
Somehow lends credibility.
Okay, so this one's called "Let Me Be Me." 1, 2, 3, 4.
Bye.
Everybody else is going to.
Which makes this song number 15.
This is the last one of us.
I think it's the right, but yeah. That's 15. Hey there.
You know what I mean?
Everybody in this band seems to sing, and somehow they've roped me into singing the last song. And there's a story behind the song, and it goes a lot like this. What happened was, from our jam group that meets about two Sundays a month, we slowly gathered this group together, and we would meet at Wolf's house from 1 to 3 on Saturdays. And Wolf, we arrived one day, and Wolf said, "Hey, I woke up early this morning, and I wrote a song. And so let's try it out." And he had a chord progression, and we started playing that, and I don't know how it happened, but I ended up starting to sing it, and I got stuck with it now. It's a bit of a Western song. I had a friend ask me, we did a video of this song, we actually performed it for the jam group once a long time ago, and I showed it to a friend, and she asked me, "Well, what's it mean?" Which took me way back, because I think it doesn't. My first reaction was, it doesn't mean anything. It's like a painting. It's like a scene, maybe a little bit of a video of just an existence, if you will. And then yesterday, I started thinking, well, it may have some sort of political content with what's going on in this country nowadays. And the song is called Blind Horse.
It's so lonely in the saddle since the horse died.
The horse died, I hope you got off the saddle.
Well, the line's in there somehow, because that's what inspired me. I read that line somewhere, and I love it. It's so lonely in the saddle since the horse died.
Oh, right!
Oh, yeah!
Well, you got it.
Here's the reason calling me.
One more song. One more round in the chamber, ladies and gentlemen. For just such possibility.
It's more like a message. Called something eternal. And he's been trying to give me the first chord for a while.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much. Great audience. Yeah.